Hey guys, how are you? Hello guys, how you doing? Good to see you guys. Hello Stacy, what's going on? Hey, can you guys see me? I'm having a little difficulty seeing you guys. Amen. Let's see here. Let's get you over this way. That's a little better, at least for me. At least for me. Great to see you guys on this wonderful. Yep. Better. It's better. Okay. You're all good. Thank you, Gloria. Better. On the clock and sneaking candy. I am so sorry. First of all, let me apologize to you guys for being so late today. A few technical difficulties. As you guys know, I am on vacation, but I want to make sure that I at least check in with you guys at 1:15-ish. That's what we've been doing this week, checking in at 1:15-ish. All right. And so I am grateful and thankful for you guys. For those of you that are new, hello, Mrs. Francis. How are you? I think I saw Stacy. I saw Gloria there. Not sure who else I saw, but hello and good day to you, whoever is there. As you know, my name is Reverend Lisa Jenkins, Pastor Jenkins. I pastor St. Matthew's in the Village of Harlem, and God has blessed me to have a ministry of empowerment, helping people find their purpose. Hello. Great to see you. For those of you also, today, my new blog post is out. Please catch it, www.lisadjenkins.org. LisaDJenkins.org is my new blog post that came out this morning, and it deals with 3 steps towards happiness. Also talk a little bit about the difference between happiness and joy, the difference between happy and joy. And so the new blog is about happiness and being happy. And the next time we'll be dealing with joy. And please check it out. Give me your thoughts. I would love to have your comments directly on the blog post. If you find it of some sort of value, please also share it with someone. You can share through Facebook. You can share through Twitter or LinkedIn. Also, you can also go to the website and please subscribe to the YouTube videos that are there, my YouTube channel as well, Lisa D. Jenkins. And I pray that would be a blessing to you. But some of you have already said that you are sneaking, that you are on the clock, and I don't want anybody sneaking. So I want to get right to this thing. Please share with somebody right now. Share. If you are on an iPhone, please swipe from the right to the left, or rather from the left to the right. Amen. If you are on an Android, swipe from top to bottom and share with someone. We're going to be talking about the scandalous things that Jesus has done. Thank you so much, Candy. But I also want to deal with empire last night, not just the Lord's empire that we've been talking about, but how many of you guys saw Empire? Anyone saw Empire last night? Just type in a 1. Don't even bother typing in Y-E-S or N-O. Just typing a 1. If you saw it, type in a 2 if you did not see it. Yes for 1. Yes, you saw Empire last night. 1. If you did not, type in a 2. Anyone, okay? Anyone for ones, all right? I, for one, saw Empire last night. I saw Empire, so we got a 2. Someone did not. Candy did. Okay, Mrs. Francis saw it. Wonderful. Okay, 1. So we got 2 yeses. We got 1 no. All right. I don't know. Stacy, I don't know what Stacy saw or who else is on. But we're going to go with that. So for those of you that saw Empire, many of you know that there's this big brouhaha about Christians watching Empire, and whether or not Christians should watch Empire, shows like Empire. You guys know how I feel about it, okay? I feel that Christians cannot separate themselves so much from situations that we have a blind eye and do not know what's going on in this world. There are some things that you might not agree with on Empire. There are some things that you don't agree with in this world, but we have to be knowledgeable. We have to know what's going on. We have to have ears to hear, eyes to see, so that we can prayerfully go to God and make the right decisions about not only our own lives, but about the gospel that we preach to others. is. And so there are so many people that say, oh, you know, it's Scandal. I can't watch Scandal. I can't watch Empire. I can't see those shows because, you know, there's too much of this on or too much of that. Let me tell you something. All of that stuff is what's in the world that we've been called to change and affect and transform. And if you don't know what you're dealing with, how are you going to be able to affect change and transformation in this world? If you don't know what it is that's going on in this world, come on, somebody. How are you going to be a change agent if you don't know what you're changing? Come on. How are you going to transform some stuff if you don't know what's to be transformed? Really now, you've got to know what is happening if you are going to be able to be of any good. We cannot be so heavily bound that we are no earthly good. And another thing about Empire, many people are saying that Empire it does not represent Black America, that Empire deals with coonery, that Lucius and Cookie, they are examples of jiggery and all sorts of terms. Let me tell you one thing. They are real. They are out there. We've got to acknowledge that Black America is not monolithic, mono one. We are not a monolithic people. We've got to realize that there are all sorts of people. There are all sorts of classes. There are differences in our community. And we are not monolithic. And so it drives me bananas when people look down their noses, because really what you are saying is that that group of people is not as good as this group of people. And that's a very dangerous thing, my brothers and sisters, when we begin to say that group of people is not as good as this group of people. And so we need to make sure that we understand that regardless of what it is, okay, what sort of segment is in that community, what sort of segment is being represented, that it is still a part of our community. And as long as it's a part of our community, as long as these people are part of God's kingdom, as part of the earth, whether it needs to be changed, transformed, done away with, eradicated, we still need to be a part of it. We need to, and when I say a part of it, we need to know and understand what's going on. Y'all feel me? We need to know and to understand what's going on. And that brings us to today's scandalous thing that Jesus dealt with. The fact that Jesus hung with sinners. Come on. Folks talking about Empire and how Christians and believers should not be watching Empire. Jesus hung with sinners. Jesus hung with tax collectors, which were looked at as the worst of sinners. Jesus hung and healed lepers. He went to lepers. He had them. He allowed them to touch him so he could touch them and he could heal them. How in the world are you going to heal a leper if you don't touch a leper? Come on, somebody. How are you going to be able to heal people and touch people if you're turning your back on them and you don't know anything about them? You've got to go out and be around these people. You've got to know them. You've got to speak their language. That's what it means to speak in tongues. We often think of speaking in tongues in that charismatic way. But in the book of Acts, okay, when they were all on one accord and they began to speak in other tongues, that translation really deals with the speaking of tongues where the people heard the folks in their own language. And we need to be able to speak the language of people out there that we don't normally deal with. Okay, I'm off on a tangent, you guys. Let's deal with this whole thing about the scandalous nature of Jesus. And another thing, anybody caught, for y'all that were on last night, anybody caught that Donnie McClurkin shade? I said I was going to talk about that. I may or may not. Okay, I may save that for tomorrow, all right? So that a few of y'all, because some folks did not know what was going on, all right? The Donnie McClurkin shade, y'all Google that, look it up, and we might deal with that tomorrow because we're running a little bit late. But Jesus dealt with tax collectors and Jesus dealt with lepers. That is so right to meet them where we got to meet people where they are. Yeah. How are you going to deal with them if you don't meet them, if you don't know them, if you can't speak their language, if you don't know the culture, if you don't know the norms, if you don't know that? I mean, really, you've got to be able to know people in order to meet people where they are and change and transform them. It makes sense. Yes. So now listen, Jesus dealt with lepers. That was scandalous. He dealt with tax collectors. All right. Let's look at Mark 1, first chapter of Mark, 40th verse. It says, a man with leprosy came to meet him, Jesus, and begged him, if you are willing, make me clean. Verse 41, it says, Jesus was indignant. That's what the New International Version says. Jesus was indignant. He reached out his hand and touched the man. Jesus reached out his hand and touched someone who no one else wanted to touch. Jesus touched someone who other people were running from, because when individuals had leprosy, they had to call out unclean and everyone else would run from them. But instead of running from them, Jesus ran to him, literally, okay, or figuratively, in the fact that he reached out and touched the man. The man said, I am willing, be clean. Leprosy left him and he was cleansed. That 41st verse struck me. Jesus was indignant, it says. Most translations say that Jesus was moved with compassion. It's a sense of indignation and compassion. Jesus was indignant. The fact that people were looking at this man in a crazy way, that this man had to come to him after being outcast, had to come to him after being torn down, had to come to him after all the priests and all the other religious authorities could not do anything for him and would not do anything for him except turn their backs on him. But Jesus was moved to compassion and touched the man that nobody else would touch, and the man was healed. We, my brothers and sisters, are called to touch people that people, others, will not touch. Other people who have folks turning their backs on them, other people who are being stepped over in the streets, other people who folks won't even give a hand out to. We have been called to touch those individuals and bring healing to them. We can heal them with our words of compassion. One of the things that strikes me in the Bible is that before Jesus performs miracles, just about every time, the Bible says that he was moved with compassion. He was moved with compassion, is what the Word of God says. My brothers and sisters, we have to be compassionate. We cannot be judgmental. We cannot look at people sideways. We cannot talk about people. That's one of the things that strikes me about the Pope. And a lot of people, particularly Baptists and Protestants, they're not understanding this whole Pope thing. But I can be Baptist and still have admiration for this man, because he has a mission of social justice and action. He is hugging people. He is loving people. And you might not always agree with some of his theology. The Pope and Roman Catholics still do not believe that women should preach the word of God. I'm a female, obviously. I believe that women are called to preach. But just because the Pope and I have differences, right? Just because the Pope and I have differences does not mean that I cannot admire the progress that is being made in the process. And so I'm grateful for him as an example of compassion. Jesus, whenever he had a miracle, he had compassion. And the Bible says that leprosy went from this person. Leprosy-like conditions will be removed from individuals when we show compassion. How many of you know bad attitudes can be like leprosy? Because leprosy was what had people flee from others, had people flee from those with leprosy. And some people have bad attitudes and you don't want to be around them. But if you show compassion, their whole demeanor can change, because sometimes people have been going through their entire life without people showing them compassion. And all they need is a word from you. All they need is a word from God through you, so that they can be made whole and they can be cleansed of whatever it is that is holding them back from operating